Hello, this is a follow-up to an earlier video that explored the new XLOOKUP function. On this occasion, we will compare the new XMATCH function with the MATCH function and see its practical applications in spreadsheets. Let's use the MATCH function, which most Excel users are familiar with, and return the index number for Delta. The match for delta should return 4. We will now road test the XMATCH to again find the delta index number of 4. Both match and XMATCH have a lookup array syntax, however XMATCH contains a match mode and search mode syntax. The match mode options are like in XLOOKUP, we will use the exact match in this instance. The search mode variables are also the same as in XLOOKUP. The match mode will use the exact match option. And the search mode will apply the search first to last variable. We should again return 4 as the match value for delta. Here is a slight alternative to the XMATCH formula. Instead, we will select exact match or next smaller item for the match mode. The search mode option will be the same, first to last. As you can see, both approaches to the XMATCH formula return the same result. We will now use the MATCH formula on a horizontal array of data. We return an index number of 6 for the gross margin value in this selected range. Let's now employ the XMATCH function. Like the earlier example, we will use the exact match option for match mode and the first to last variable for the search mode. We again tweak the match mode in XMATCH and return the same result by selecting exact match or next smaller item for the match mode. We can realize the same result of 6. Let's look at the impact of the match mode further with XMATCH. One restriction with match is the fact only the first value will be returned. In this case, the index number for Q1 will always be 1. We will apply a wildcard search and return the first index number for Q in our quarter data range. Again, we return the index number value of 1. What value will we get with XMATCH? For the match mode, we will select exact match and search first to last for the search mode variable. XMATCH returns the same value as match, an index value of 1. Once more, we will use XMATCH, but this time we will select search last to first for the search mode. Hence, the index number returned will be 4 from the selected quarter data range. How does a wildcard lookup value handle XMATCH? Clearly, for the search mode, we choose wildcard character match. Whereas we again choose search first to last for the search mode. XMATCH again returns 1. What is the index number for EBITDA percentage? The match function returns 8. How do we fare using XMATCH? Once more, we will use the exact match as the match mode. As well as the search first to last as the search mode, these variables will again return 8. Let's revisit the search mode of XMATCH. First, we will do a wildcard lookup of Roses Dust in our SKU line items in this example. Based on an exact match, we shall return the index number of 3. If we instead select another match type such as less than, it results in an erroneous result. Clearly, the 8th line item in this data array doesn't contain Roses Dust. This is a shortfall with match. We will now perform a wildcard search using Roses Dust, but with the XMATCH function. As we can see, the function returns the correct value of 3. Like XLOOKUP, XMATCH has the ability, unlike MATCH, to return the last value in a data array. This example uses the Roses Dust wildcard value again and selects the search last to first for the search mode. The index number for the last wildcard value in the range is in fact 5, which XMATCH correctly returns.